Phillip takes a stand.
Well, let's see. These trucks need to go here. Oh, and those tar wagons need to go over there. Yikes! Morning, Phillip. Good morning, Thomas. I wish it was a good morning.
Poor Phillip. Ever since he found out Vinnie was on Sodor, he became a nervous wreck. Each little sound he heard, he shuddered in fear.
Good morning, Phillip.
Good morning, Henry.
Oh dear, what's wrong? Did you fill up on some bad fuel?
It's not that, it's... Ah! I found out that Vinnie was on Sodor and I don't know what he's going to do with me. I wish that he was back home instead of here.
None of us wants him here, Phillip, especially me. I still remember how he mocked me at the Great Railway Show.
Do you honestly think you can beat me? Looks like that you can only pull 10 freight cars. Empty, I might add.
I am going to do my best, and if I win...
If you win, how many contests have you won?
Well,
I thought so. I've won many contests back home. You don't deserve to be here.
Oh, Henry, that's awful.
The sad part is that he did beat me.
Maybe you should do a rematch.
It is not my nature to compete with that terrible bully.
Henry was passing Marin Station when he saw Vinnie nearby.
I am still waiting for a thank you and an apology, Henry called out.
I don't do apologies, Vinnie wheesh.
You're a real piece of work, Henry muttered.
Later on, Henry was telling everyone all about Phillip.
So we need to do our part to protect Phillip, Henry told them.
You can count me in, Henry, chuffed Thomas.
Phillip helped me out of a jam once, so now we must help him in return, said James.
Sodor engines must stick together, said Percy.
The next day, Phillip was shunting trucks at Brendam Docks. He was just shunting some empty trucks for Cranky to load up when...
Hey, be more careful! Oh, it's you, Shorty.
Vinnie!
I just had a great idea. How about if I push you into the sea and...
You will do no such thing!
Henry stormed in, followed by Percy, James, and Thomas.
What do you all want? Vinnie huffed.
What we want is for you to stop bullying Phillip, shouted James.
So what did he ever do to you? Oh, that's right, nothing,
wheeshed Percy.
Don't you remember, snorted Vinnie. He got in my way at the Great Railway Show.
Is that it, snapped Thomas.
No, because of him, I've been banned from future railway shows.
So you're blaming him? You've got yourself banned, yelled Henry.
The argument went on and on. This made Cranky very cranky. So cranky, he dropped a crate of oranges onto the quayside.
Will you all shut up and let me work in peace? He shouted.
Henry, James, Percy, and Thomas steamed away in a huff.
I'll talk to you later, shrimp, sneered Vinnie.
Phillip quivered in fear.
Thank you.
Phillip saw.
Why can't he just leave me alone? I didn't do anything wrong.
We all know that, Phillip, Sue Henry. We'll still protect you no matter what.
Later, Vinnie was pulling a heavy goods train to Great Waterton.
Next time I see that pipsqueak, he'll be flat as a pancake.
But because he was thinking about Phillip, Vinnie missed a signal and went on to the wrong line. Meanwhile, Phillip was taking some scrap to the scrapyard. Suddenly, he saw Vinnie heading straight towards him. Phillip blew his horn in terror. He and Vinnie had stopped in the middle of a crossing. The big North American engine glared down at Phillip.
What do you think you're doing? Get out of my way, you useless engine!
You know what? No! I will not move out of the way! Yelled Phillip.
What did you say to me, you little shrimp?
You heard me! I had enough of you! You're in my way! So move aside! Snapped Phillip.
Never! I don't listen to little pipsqueaks like you! Plus, I'm not the one that missed a signal! Snorted Vinnie.
Yes, you did! Yelled Phillip.
Phillip? What's wrong?
One word. Vinny, I'm not going to tolerate his bullying for another second.
Last chance to move out of the way, said Vinny. If you insist, get ready. You're going to be recycled. I beg your pardon. What did you say, Vinny?
Vinny gasped. There stood Sir Topham Hatt. Thomas was taking him to Farquhar. He had heard everything and was very cross.
Sir, I was silence!
First of all, you are on the wrong line. Second, how dare you treat Phillip like that? You will immediately return to Knapford Sheds after delivering your goods train to Great Waterton. I'll speak to you later.
As for you, Phillip, I'm very proud of you. It takes a lot of bravery to stand up to a bully. You're a really useful engine.
Phillip beamed with pride. Later, Phillip told the other engines what had happened.
Well, Henry isn't the only one that put Vinnie in his place, smiled James. Well done, Phillip!
I bet Sir Topham Hatt would send him away for sure,
smiled Percy. Henry looked at Phillip, then smiled and winked. Phillip smiled a big smile in return. As for Vinny, well, when he arrived at Knapford Sheds, he was exiled by the other engines, so he set off to find a new shed. Eventually, he found an old engine shed near Maithwaite. It took half an hour for Sir Topham Hatt to look for Vinnie, but once he found him, he stormed up to him.
You're a very, very despicable engine, Vinnie. I should send you home right now. However, Murdoch is still getting repaired, so I'm giving you one last chance.
But
so help me for once. If I see you disrespect any of my engines again, you will be sent home. Is that clear?
Yes, Vinnie sulked.
Sir Topham Hatt turned and stormed away. For the first time in his life, Vinnie felt alone and uncertain what lays ahead for him. But we can agree that he deserves no sympathy at all.